The story so far. Over the past couple of videos, I've been putting together a Blazor application to display book reviews coming from a backend API, and also to display a summary of those reviews that just gives you the average. And also, that second part of it, I did using test-driven development and unit tests with XUnit and a library especially for Blazor called bUnit. And so what we've ended up with is something looking like this. So here's our application. If I go to book reviews, there we can see all of the reviews. And if I go to review summaries, we can see we've just got the four distinct books, and those are the average ratings based on the other reviews. And then the other thing we had in there, as I mentioned, was we had the unit tests. So if we just go in here and go to the Test Explorer, then we can see we've got a number of tests that are passing. And if we take a look at the test here, this was the test on the component itself. But what we've done here is only really tested the programming interface of our component. So that summaries, if we look at the definition of it, you can see it's that public property that we set up. We know it's working correctly, but what we haven't tested is the visuals of the component itself. So if we go into pages and look at our review summaries in the Razor page for it, we can see that it takes that summaries that we've just written our tests against and then turns them into rows in a table. Now, there's not that much that could go wrong there because there's very little logic compared to what we have in our code behind, but it's still a good idea to test that we've got that correctly so that we're getting the right number of rows and that we're getting the title and the rating and that sort of thing. And that's the additional thing that this nice library bUnit provides for us. So if we go into the test code for the page, remember we've already set up that one test, and the way we did that was with this test context that comes to us from bUnit. We set up some mock data, so just a couple of books with ratings of 1 and 2 on average, did a load of configuration there. Then remember, we used that test context to render our page, and that was how we got back the summaries. But we're now going to use that to look at the page itself to check that the HTML elements have the correct values. So let's do that. Let's put in another test, and this one we are going to call display summaries. So fetch summaries checked that it got the data, and then display summaries is going to check that it displays it in the correct way. And bear in mind, we're going to have the same setup as we had before because it's happening in the constructor, so it gets run just before every test. So our mock data and everything is going to be the same. So what we now do is I'm going to say var cells and then equals, and then remember this underscore page is this wrapper of type iRender component around the actual page that we've got. Previously, we called instance to get at the object itself, but now on the page, I can actually just do this find all. And this allows us to do a CSS style selection to start getting hold of elements within the page itself. If we look at the page, we can see this is the structure. And what we want to test for is basically to make sure, in terms of this test data, that we have two rows because we had book one and book two, and that row one has a title of book one and a rating of one, and that row two has a title of book two and a rating of two. So just nice simple test data. So we need to get hold of these TDs. And as I say, we do that just with normal CSS selection. So I'm going to say table, which has an immediate descendant T body, which has an immediate descendant TR, which has an immediate descendant TD. So arrow means immediate descendant. And so that should basically give us all of the TDs that we have in there. And you can see that's going to be a collection of these elements. Then all we need to do is do an assert on collection. So that's all very nice. And then check that each one is correct. So there should be 4 cells because we've looked for the TDs, 2 rows with 2 in each. So I'm going to do C for cell, gives, and then we're going to say assert dot equal. And then I'm expecting the first cell to to be book 1. And so I can say c.innerHTML, and that should give me the content. And then we just need to do that 3 more times. So each one in turn. So that one's going to be book 2. That one is going to be 1. But notice 1 as a string, because we're out of the realm of numbers now. It's just what's getting displayed. And that one's going to be 2. Again, because that's the mock data we created there. And so that should just work as a test. And so if we run that, we should now see that display summary is giving us the correct answer. So pretty simple, but now means we can actually be doing unit tests on what is displayed, not simply on the code behind, which is a useful thing to do. And actually, it can tell us something else, because if we look at the actual results we've got here, we can see that the display isn't really particularly neat, because we're dealing with averages here, and you can see that we've got 4.25 and 3.25 when there are decimal places, but also we've just got 3 and 4 when it's a whole number. And indeed, if the numbers were a bit different, then we would be getting things that were more than 2 decimal places. So in fact, if I just cheat that a little bit and go back in here and add a new review for, say, Dr. No with a value of 1, add that in there. We will be doing our own code to add new items. But now you can see the average is just horrible and we've got far too many decimal places. So clearly we want to fix that. And also, we'd like to have a test to make sure we've done that correctly. And as ever, let's write the test first. So let's go back to our test code and actually put in what we really want. That one should be 1.00. That one should be 2.00. That should show us that we've got the precision correct. And if we run that, obviously that's now going to fail because it was working before with 1 and 2. So just a nice thing that we can have in a test to make sure the display is really how we want it. Fixing it is dead simple because remember, everything that we're doing in the Razor page, we can do C# stuff. And it's very easy to have the correct precision there. So we need to change this rating. First thing I need to do is put some round brackets around that so that the Razor engine knows that all of this is part of the Razor. Then I'm just going to use C# string interpolation. So once we're in Razor, we're in the realms of C#. So we will wrap that in curly braces. But then also, just by simply putting :n2, that is the normal C# way of doing 2 decimal places of precision. So that's all you need to do. And if we run the tests again, we're now getting green lights. And if we run the program again, we can see that now it's nice and neat, 2 decimal places, not that gobbledygook we had before. So that was pretty simple. 2 things to look at there. One was the idea of using bUnit to actually test what we've got inside the HTML, and if we just take a look at the code we had for that, we can see we've got this thing like the find all, we've got the inner HTML, lots more features there for helping you find the appropriate element and also look at its content or its attributes or things like that. So all sorts of things in there. And then we also saw the fact that having written a test like that, we can verify that we've got something correct visually, like the precision. And we also saw how easy it is to do that. Coming from an Angular background for this sort of thing, that's done in a different way using things called pipes. And so my first instinct is to think, what is the equivalent of a pipe in Blazor? Well, we don't have to have one because we've got the whole of C#. And if you know how to do it in C#, which we do, then that's what we have there. So that was a fairly quick one on the second half of what we can do with unit testing and bUnit. Still got some other things to look at in terms of writing forms and also using CSS. So those are coming up. But if you enjoyed that, do click like, do subscribe, and I'll see you next time.